to start with the new session in Blisters Conquered, that is analysis of Blisters Conquered Bane. We are going to see now today new concept. That concept is called as a strength concept. Earlier we have seen the two concept. That first concept is a stress concept, and second concept you have seen as a load balancing concept. So today we are going to see the third concept, and that is a strength concept. What is the strength concept that we are going to see now today? So our main aim in Blisters Conquered beam is to calculate the stresses at various sections, at mid section, at end section of the beam. Okay, so here just I am going to do what is strength concept. For that, first I am going to tell you, suppose this is beam which is laid on the ground. Okay, this is placed on the ground, and a stress force is going to apply to this beam, and through this tendon, and tendon is plus with the eccentricity. What happens when you are going to apply the force to tendon, and when you are going to cut the tendon, the force is going to act like this here. Okay, first thing in strength concept, we have to know first what the line which is transferring the pre-stressing force. That line we are going to call it as a P line or the P force line. Okay, so here the force is going to transfer through this tendon, so this line we are going to consider as a P line. So figure number one, I have shown the pre-stress beam which is placed on a ground without any superimposed load, any external load, and without any end condition. Beam is simply laid on a ground. Okay, and just figure number two, I have shown the P force acting on the tendon. So through this tendon, the P force going to act on the tendon. Okay, now come to the figure number three. So figure number three, when pre-stressing force is applied on the tendon, same way the force, the stress is going to act on concrete also. Okay, due to this the stresses are going to develop in a concrete, and the action of force on the concrete, that line is called as a C force, or that C force line. Okay, acting. And suppose if I am going to place the beam exactly on the ground, flat ground, and if I am going to apply the forces through this tendon, so the C line, the concrete line, and the tendon P force line, remember, please understand, the P line is nothing but the P force line, the line which is going to act in the line of tendon which we are going to provide it. And the C line is a line where the concrete stresses are going to develop. Okay, the C line is a pressure on the concrete. So that C line, now when beam is simply laid on the ground without any external forces, the self weight is also not going to act. In that case, P line and C line is going to coincide to each other, because the way we are going to apply the P force, through this tendon we are going to apply on the beam, so the action line is concrete line and the tendon line will be same. But the moment when we are going to apply the external load, okay, any external load on this beam, or the beam is subjected, or beam is subjected on the simply support. Now here the beam is not going to lay down on ground. If the moment you are going to place beam here with the simple support, in that case this beam is going to bend. So in that case the C line is going to change its position, because now beam is subjected with the bending moment also, like this. Okay, beam is going to bend like this, and due to bending this line, C line, is going to change its position. Okay, along with the P line. This is P line. Okay, here you can see this is P line and this is C line. So C line is going to change its position. Why it is going to change its position? Because due to the external load or the self weight of the beam. Because here end condition, we have given the simple support condition. So beam is going to bend due to the self weight, and moment is going to generate here. The moment, when the moment is going to develop in the beam, the line, P line and C line, is not coincide to each other. In that case, the C line is going to differ from P line. Okay, already you know P line is nothing but a tendon line that remain going to same here. Okay, but C line is going to change, the concrete action, the concrete force line is going to change, and the distance through which the line is changed, that distance we are going to call it as A. Okay, and that A is called as a shift of the line C, shift of the line C from the P line. Okay, P line and C line, remember P line is the force line due to the tendency line. This is the concrete line. Concrete stresses okay going to act on the concrete in the beam. Okay, and how to get this value? This A value you are going to get from the formula M by P. Okay, so M by P here, moment on the beam, suppose self weight of beam, that self weight of beam W square by it, you are going to get the moment, and this is force. Okay, and how to calculate the extreme stresses in the beam? So extreme stresses in the beam you are going to calculate by using this formula. So here plus C by A, C is a concrete line, the force to the concrete, okay, divided by cross section area of the beam, C into eccentricity. Now what is eccentricity? The eccentricity here is the distance, eccentricity of C line, not the eccentricity of P line. Where is the C line? The distance of C line from the CG centroidal axis, that distance is called as the eccentricity, and that eccentricity we have to consider. And always remember one thing, while considering the value of C, you are not supposed to take value of A as eccentricity. Okay, here E have to take as the eccentricity. And what is E? E is the eccentricity of line CA. C line eccentricity we have to consider as the small a. And by using this formula, we are going to calculate the extreme stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. So hope that you have got the concept. Simple concept here. The beam having the two lines, P line and C line. P line is a tender line where we apply the force. That force line is a P line. And C line is a concrete line. Okay, the stresses are going to develop due to concrete. That line is called a C line. Figure number 1 and figure number 3, I have shown the position of C line and P line same, because the ground, the beam is rest on a ground. So it is not going to bend with this self weight or any external load is going to apply to the beam. The moment I have changed the end condition of the beam, I have placed the beam on the simple connection, simple support. In that case, beam is liable to bend due to its self weight. And that case moment is going to develop, and due to that moment, C line is going to change from its position. The distance through which the C line is going to change from P line, that is called as a small m, and that we are going to calculate by using M by P formula. M is equal to moment here, self weight of beam or external load, that W square by 8 we are going to consider, and P is a force, okay, stress force. And next here, extreme stresses, that we are going to consider direct stresses here, and here bending stresses. Now bending stresses due to C force and the eccentricity, and here the C force divided by A, and we are going to consider while solving the problem, the C force is C is nothing but a P. Okay, so C is equal to P are going to consider, and we are going to calculate the forces. Okay, so we are going to calculate the stresses at midsection and end section of the beam. Okay, hope that you have got the concept. Now based upon this concept, we are going to solve a problem now. So see the problem here. So problem statement: a pre-stressed concrete beam 400 by 600 mm in section has a span of 7 meter and is subjected with the UDL of 18 kN per meter including self weight of beam. The pre-stressing tendon which are located along the longitudinal central axis provided an effective pre-stressing force of 1200 kN. So pre-stressing force 1200 kN, and we have to determine the extreme stresses at mid span of the section. Okay, so for this first thing, required thing, we have to calculate as usual the cross section area of the beam, that is a 400 by 600 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 section modulus z, pd square by 6, already you know this. So this only become 2.4 into 10 raised to 7. Maximum bending moment WL square by 8. So W they have given here 18 including the self weight of beam, so 18 into L square 7 divided by 8, so 110.25 kN meter. Now shift of C line from P line. Remember, while strength concept, you have to calculate the value of A. So value of A, so what is A first? Well, A is shift of line C from P. Now due to that movement, the first we have to calculate shift. How much shift of between the line P and line C? So by using this formula M by P, moment you have calculated 110.25 to 10 raised to 6. Divided by pre-stressing force 1200 into 10 raised to 3, so that shift value, the distance between the P line and C line will be here 91.88. Okay, so we have got value of A now here. So here remember one thing, the eccentricity of line E we are going to consider as 91.88. why? Because the tendon is provided here at the central axis, means tendon is not provided with an eccentricity. So tendon is provided here, okay. So the C line and P line, okay, so the C line and P line, so is going to act in same thing, okay. So when I am going to calculate the eccentricity, so eccentricity I am going to always measure from center, okay. So that's why here the C line and P line will be same, and that's why the eccentricity we are going to keep as the same, okay. So eccentricity of line E is equal to 91.88, so that value you are going to consider A is equal to E, and we are going to calculate the stresses. So stress, direct stresses of distressing force, direct stress here C by A, so that we are going to consider 200 into 10 raised to 3 and divided by area, so that value become 5 Newton per mm square. Extreme stress due to bending moment, so here C into eccentricity, so that value is plus minus 4.59 Newton per mm square. And at last, final stresses by considering the here plus sign, here minus sign due to this, okay, we are going to get the maximum value at top fiber stresses 9.59 and bottom fiber 0.41, okay. And this values we are going to show in the this diagram, cross section, direct stresses, bending stresses and final stresses, okay, at top stresses, and this is bottom stresses. So direct, bending and combined stresses. So this how we are going to solve the problem or calculate the stresses by using the strength concept, okay. Hope that you understood the concept of strength and how to calculate the stresses by using the formula of strength concept, okay. Next lecture we are going to solve one problem by using three concept, okay. One problem by using three concept, that stress concept, strength concept and load balancing concept, okay. So we are going to stop here. Thank you.